Hello, dissenters. My name is Etalyx, and I am here in Just Cause 3 as Rico, Lord of the Butterflies. They called me the Monarch. Today, we are going to exert our dominance over all sorts of red-colored buildings by blowing them up, shooting them. We're going to start by liberating a small base to give you a little taste of what you're going to be doing quite a lot of in Just Cause 3. Okay, maybe we need to start over. Let's try this one more time. I'm going to hide out on the roof. Select my explosives. Plant it on satellites and anything else I can get my hands on without them seeing me. Let's try and... Okay, they're just sitting in a pickup truck for no discernible reason. Listening to the radio, maybe something more sinister. I'll let you decide. Start with a little firework action. Switch back to my old automatic pistols. Now, how can we bring this giant tower down? That is a new question. Is there anything useful, perhaps? Maybe we can just get this gate out of here, make a little entrance for myself, and just ignore the hail of bullets coming in my general direction. I am here exclusively to cause mayhem. We're going to make a tiny adjustment in the barrel before we attach it to the leg of this tower, creating a cylindrical rocket device, which is just enough momentum and energy to bring it tumbling down around us. Now things are getting a little more hectic. The heat level has risen to level 2. And you always know, in Just Cause, if you're shooting people to death, you're probably really boring and lacking in imagination. The first thing anyone will try is getting two people attached to the arm together and zipping them headbutting headlong into their death. And here come the rest. Let's see if we can switch things up. Maybe do a little high-flying action instead. Make ourselves a bit more scarce, more difficult to pin down. As we swoop back around for our final attack. Well, I was hoping it was going to be my final attack, because if all of them exploded at the same time, it would have looked a lot cooler, you know? Instead, now I've got to, like, I ran out of ammo, and this gun right here is a single-shot-only gun, and there is now an attack helicopter! Thank you for bringing some ammunition my way. I wanted to give you, just for those of you who may have missed out on the beauty of a game that was Just Cause 2, a little example of what you can expect from this chaotic mayhem. This is the whole point of the game, to make everything explode in the most glorious, dramatic way possible. And Just Cause 3 succeeds in that it takes everything that was fun about Just Cause 2 and just adds more. It's not a wildly different game. When I first started playing Just Cause 3, I was like, wow, this feels exactly how I remember 2, which is not an awful thing. All of the controls were familiar immediately. I can zip around wherever I want. I can ride underneath helicopters, drop down, except now there's new things, like the wingsuit, to give you even more control over how fast you want to go. And so the question then becomes, should I buy Just Cause 3, Etalyx? Well, did you ever think to yourself, self, I really wish there was just even more zany and wacky things for me to do in Just Cause 2? Because that's exactly what this is. Can I drive this tractor, please? Please tell me I can drive this tractor. Please, just get out of my sight. I want to drive you. I can. I stole my own tractor. I'm going to take this back to my garage so I can have it whenever I want. Just Cause 3 is not going to revolutionize open world games. Okay, it's just not. It's the same thing. You go around the map and you liberate bases. You blow things up. And this tractor is probably the worst vehicle in the entire game. And that's why I love it. Let's open up the map and you can see what I'm saying. Same old, challenges. Do you love driving challenges? Do you love flying through rings? Do you enjoy just blowing things up for the sake of blowing things up, or perhaps just driving up a mountain just because you can? The good news here is that even though the whole game is filled with fluff content, those fluff contents are meaningful in that by completing these different challenges, you get gears. And with gears, you head on over to the gear mods page, which allows you to upgrade Rico. So everything is ready from the get-go. They each have certain costs associated with them. So you have to complete certain challenges to get certain gears. But I love that that fluff actually has meaning. And that's what separates it a little bit. It's not just there for the sake of being there. It's there to give you some new toys. So if you thought to yourself, hey, I'd love to tether six things at the same time, they know. They know you want to just play in a physics sandbox, so they're going to just give you things that make your free play that much more enjoyable, which I very much appreciate. That is a really heavy person that just pulled that car backwards. See you later, compadre. So if you need to get more beacons, which I need to do in order to get some supply drops, we're going to have to find a rebel base and or liberate a town to create a rebel base. So let's see where the nearest outpost is. We can't actually liberate Costa di Ravello, so how about we just go ahead and make that happen? Shooting the guys who are trying to call in reinforcements to keep our heat level down. Now, what are we supposed to blow up, you might be asking? Check out the left top side of the screen. That has a number of different icons that indicate what you need to do. So unfortunately, we are going to have to kind of do the boring way of knocking down that statue after all, since I can't quite have an attack helicopter yet. You might be wondering, Etalyx, what is with that funky crosshair? It's got like an X, and sometimes it has a rotating icon. The rotating icon indicates when you can use your grapple to pull yourself along, and the X is just the default crosshair. And the reason it's an X instead of a more precise icon is quite simply because the game helps you aim, especially if you're using a controller. Let's try not to die here while we zoom up to the helicopter through the explosion, because we're just that cool. We're totally not dead. We didn't just headbutt the helicopter as the helicopter exploded from the counter explosion of the gas tanks. What was I even talking about? Okay, I remember now. That just refreshed my memory a little bit. The game helps you aim, especially if you're using a controller. It's going to just point you in the general direction of the enemy you're trying to hit, and you will hit him, even if your crosshair is not perfectly on top of him, and I like that. I just want to have fun. I don't want to try to be a pro elite gamer right now. I want to zoom around and do cool things, and that aim assist helps you do cool things. So, I don't know how much it affects you with a mouse and keyboard, but it's kind of beside the point. Alright, how are we going to drag this statue down? Probably something to do with one of these heavy-duty vehicles right here, so let's do a little hijacking. Alright, get out of my car. We're going to kill a couple people along the way. Let's jump in! We can even take on the turret if we want to as well, but we're fairly safe in here, I like to think. Take a couple people out. Civilians, get out of the road. Do you hear all the explosions? All right, let's turn around and do this a little bit better. Now, two options. We can either pull it down, which is the old-fashioned way, or we can just shoot it with the machine gun. Now, one thing I will want to talk about is that I am not particularly fond of the vehicle driving. The steering is very bizarre. Look at this camera. The camera angle is probably the worst offender here. It's so close! So we can just place a few little explosive devices around his toes and help him tie his shoes, and then, of course, fly away and detonate. You might be able to say we just crippled the dictator's control over this area. Don't laugh all at once. Are you thinking what I'm thinking? Rocket-boosted car, perhaps? Sir, very important business right now. Do you understand that I've got things that I'm trying to do? And I don't need anyone to interfere with me right now. Alright, so we have to be very careful here not to make the canister explode. I'm sure it will be fine. It's okay. We're not gonna run over our own canister. It's not okay. Yes, rocket boosted car is now working! Somehow this is happening. No problems, guys. No problems. That was all intentional. Completely 100% meant to do that. Right, here's what we're actually going to do. We're going to try unnecessarily complicating this task by driving by the billboard. Hi. Didn't quite go as planned. All right, let's just do this the easy way. See, that's kind of the problem with Just Cause 3, right? Is that occasionally you just want to try to do something really cool just for the sake of doing something cool. But it's just way easier just to shoot everything until you win. And that is how you liberate an outpost. We only have but one thing left to do, and that is to call in the rebel reinforcements. So let's try to find the waypoint for that. But, you know, then again, that's also Just Cause 3's strength, isn't it? It's that it gives you so much free time to try to do whatever cool thing it is you want to do, however you want to do it. They give you that opportunity. And if you want to do it, you can't. It's kind of like in games where you can sneak around, but you don't have to. You could just shoot everyone to death in that stealth game, but you don't. Why? Because it's more rewarding to do it the other way. And that's what I like about Just Cause 3, is trying to find the more rewarding way to do the easy thing. All right, now seriously, where is the, like, call-in button for the... I have to call in two different sets of rebels somehow. Here's a few rebels that are gonna help us out. Nice shotguns, guys. Can I just comment and say the shooting and gunplay in Just Cause 3 feels significantly improved over Just Cause 2? The time to kill is very short. All enemies go down in just a couple of bullets, and it feels so much more satisfying because of that. I really, really love that. Alright guys, got bad news for you. I've missed every single tether, but the bad guys are now taking cover BEHIND THE EXPLOSIVE BARRELS! You crazy? I was trying to do this overcomplicated, like, setup for the thing, like, just to attach them and make them, like, run around. No, they just took cover. Who are you shooting at, by the way? Oh, you're not on our team, you're on the other team. Anyways, guys, this is not really a review of Just Cause 3 or anything, and I think I finally have the ability to call in a drop now, so let us make that attempt. We've got a beacon. We've tossed a beacon. The jet is coming in with my new cargo. And as you capture more and more vehicles... Are you serious right now? Hang on, are you serious right now? This is brand new mint condition, fresh out of the box. How is it already on fire? You rebel scum. Giving me these used goods. This helicopter's not even drivable. I was gonna make like an epic helicopter like this is the end of the video segment. You've ruined it! But really, I just wanted to make a video because I'm having fun in Just Cause 3. It is definitely more of the same from Just Cause 2, but not necessarily in a bad way. It just feels like there is a lot more variety in terms of how to take down each individual base, especially given the fact that you have the option to... Oh, no, 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 no. I am not allowed to have fun. Am I not allowed to have fun? I guess I needed to hack all of the SAMs before I'm allowed to have fun. So thank you guys so much for watching this video as I clumsily claw my way out of the water. I think I'm biting off a little more than I can chew here at this base. I'm still kind of a newbie Rico, and I'm getting shot down as soon as I go airborne. So I'm gonna try to unlock a stronger Rico, get some new weapons. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Etalyx, and I'll see you next time.